Par 4, 415 yards. 415 yards. Karl driver. He's hit the fairway with his driver. He only hit one fairway with his driver on the front nine and finished that nine even par. So let's see if he can up that average. Oh, Karl munched his drive. Just got a three-quarter pitching wedge here. It's a little bit short, won't be happy with that. He was expecting to put that inside of 6 feet. I think it got a bit more spin than he was expecting. He was expecting that to hit, bounce once and then stop. Instead it spun back directly. After missing a gimme on the ninth, well not a gimme, but a 6 footer on the ninth, Karl's going to need to start dropping a few of these gettable putts. He's made a few from 25 odd feet, but you don't expect to make those, but these ones here you'd expect to get your fair share. They're not a gimme, not guaranteed, but the players that are 5 under make their fair share of these. Think it's in. Didn't hit it. 11th hole, 337 par 4. I doubt if Karl will use driver. He'll just use hybrid and then a 3-quarter wedge. Down the high diddle diddle is drivable if players want to give the longest hitters, want to give their driver a real big rip, 337 yards, but Karl's opted for hybrid and a 3-quarter wedge. Karl with around 95 to 100 yards. That's more like it. Really good shot. See, that one didn't rip back. So that's the exact same shot that he was trying to play a couple of holes back when it ripped back. Karl's just had the luxury of seeing the putt coming from the other side, so he should be allowing a cup and a half from his right to left. Only broke a cup. I would have thought it would break more than that too. So there's right, the first par 5 on the back nine up for grabs. 566 yards. No water in play. Sprayed that out to the right again. eagle putt here after a really good hybrid into this hole. See what I mean? Seems to like it. Yeah, just off the left edge of the green there. He's got uphill putt for birdie. It's a good tee shot here. Say the pace was wrong, the pace was good, but if it was that foot faster, it was in the hole. Yeah, I know, son. Oh my. 14th par 4, 443 will be driver wedge for Karl today. 14th, one under for the round. Still got these last five holes left. Playing ready golf. So Gal's playing partners are putting out on the previous hole. And Karl's been asked to tee off. Doesn't look happy with it, but that's not to say it's not a good shot. Stood a chance of dancing with the princess, did it? Rushing. In all likelihood, well, I don't think that there's any likelihood, any doubt that this group is going to finish in pitch black. So they're the last group off, and it's just starting to get dark now. Still with four holes left to play. Right, 15, four holes to play. Tried on the 15th. Into the wind, which is coming into them and off the left. With that, it's ready golf. As soon as they're ready, they can hit. for birdie. Good shot from where he was. A few of them. Mm-hmm. 16th hole, par 5, 537 yards today. Straight down the middle. Right, three holes to go. We're on 16, par 5, Karl's. One down the middle, into the wind though, so that would have taken about 20 yards off, but reachable in two for him. But the wind's really gusting a bit now, and Karl's split the fairway into the wind with his driver. He's got his two hybrid in his hands here. He's going to be shooting this across the water to the par 5 green up there. There's hope that he's got enough club here. The wind is going to hurt this. Doesn't like it. He was really having to hit that hybrid hard. You can see his coach there having his input into what he thinks. I mean, his college coach. I'm not sure what they're discussing here. It could be trying to figure out if it's in a burrowing hole. Right, so Karl looks like he's going to play this from, not sure if he took a drop, but looks like he's played it pretty well. Right. Assuming that Karl took the unplayable, this will be for a par. So it looks like he's incurred a bogey on a, I wouldn't say easy par 5, but on a par 5 where he should be making birdie. Players are playing the back tee, so it's 180 yards with the wind coming off of the left. About 10 miles an hour of wind. So after, to quote Karl, the masterful escape that he had on the last hole to make his par. He steps up into the par 317, 180 yards, wind coming off of the left. The wind's picked up to about 10-15 miles an hour just in the last hole or so. Requires a bit of a draw against the breeze. Oh, great shot. Very good. Right, he came about 40 feet here. no doubt tell me later it was 50 feet. And he'll probably be closer to the real length than I will. I'll see if I can keep track of the ball after it leaves this putter. Great speed. The boys are rushing. It's so easy to, when you're rushing, to hit it 6 feet past because you're out of your normal tempo. So 180 wind off the left, you'll take your par three and walk off. Let's have a look at the numbers on the 18th here. Par 4, 461 yards. 18th hole. Still one under for the round. He's striking that driver well at the end of the round. Need to do it for most of the round for the next couple. You can see here that Karl's absolutely dissected this fairway into a 15 mile an hour breeze. Tempo, but I'm afraid the wind might have grabbed that. Right, come on, miss the green pin, all right? Putter in hand. Good speed.
Make it.
Oh, good effort. Karl finished one under for the round.